Now let's look at text frames. As images go in image frames, text goes in text frames. I click on the text frame tool. The text frame tool is above the image frame tool. Now I drag to create a text frame. When you double click on the frame, you get a blinking cursor, and you can type text. I will fill the frame with some sample text. I right click on the frame and choose sample text. I click on OK. To move the text frame, click on the select item tool, or press the escape key. I can move the text frame and change its size. In the properties panel, I can rotate the frame. To rotate from the center, place the base point in the center. You can also rotate from a corner. As with image frames, I can edit the shape of the frame. I open shape and click on edit. Let's say I want to rotate the frame, but want the text to stay horizontal. I will rotate with 10 degree increments. I can drag the nodes. And I can add nodes and move them. And for making curves, I click on move control points. To get smooth curves, use move control point symmetrical. I will rotate the frame. I click on OK. Like we did with images, we can use a shape for a text frame. Let's create a circle again. I keep the shape icon pressed down and choose the ellipse tool. I drag and hold control press down. I right click on the circle, go to convert to and choose text frame. I right click on the circle again and choose sample text. To let the text follow the form better, in the text properties, I click on align text justified. I decrease the size of the text. We now see, the last line of a paragraph isn't justified. To also force the last line to the right edge, choose align text force justified. In the text properties we see, by default, fixed line spacing is selected. I can change the line spacing by scrolling in the entry field. I can also choose automatic line spacing. To hide the black border, open colors and select stroke. Then click on none. To hide the margin and frame outlines, I go to view, preview, preview mode. Now let's see how to import text from, for example, a Word document. I drag a text frame. I right click on the text frame and choose get text. I select a Word document and click on OK. I have now imported the content of the Word document. We see we have some text formatting in the document, like the underlining of text and different font sizes. If you want to import only the text, but without any predefined formatting, do the following. I create a new text frame. I right click on the text frame and choose get text. I select the Word document again. This time I select import text only. I click on OK. Now we have the same text, but in only one size and with only one font. The reason the text at the left looks so different is because in Word, paragraph styles were applied to the text. And this is the subject of the next lecture.